Hail, fiery ones of God, be determined in thy God's center, and thou shalt prevail over the enemy. Most gracious Chelas, do be seated. We are here at the turning of the year and of cycles. As our Lord has spoken, we are here because we are the determined ones. And if there are blank seats, then I say across the land and the world, where are you this day? Those of you who are the lovers of the will of God, you have not yet known me. You have not understood the tenderness of my heart, the fierceness of my spirit that could, if you would, propel you into infinite cycles beyond this universe to a place prepared for you, beloved. So take my heart. Take my message, take the will of God, and let the fire burn within you in such an intensity that you will simply not allow this civilization to go down. Why, you do have a holy Christ self, you do have a mighty I Am presence, and you do have compassionate hearts. So then, my most beloved, I come and I ask you with that fervor, the fervor even of Jesus and Lord Maitreya and Sanat Kumara, I come to say that no man, no devil, no fallen angel can cause you to move an inch if you do not allow it. Do not give in to unreality, but enter in to that eternality of white fire that commands and commands and commands the soul to be made whole. Listen to your holy Christ self. Listen to your Lord and Savior. Obey immediately. Follow in his footsteps and know that the will of God will lead you home. And if you say, I shall do this that Moria wishes another day, you will lose that cycle and you may not come back to it in this life. Therefore, keep your attunement. Keep that attunement, beloved. And do not allow any of these individuals who have left the path, for they are the ones who have gone sour. And are they ever sour, beloved, when they decide to be? Well, I tell you, the next thing after being sour is to be rotten. And so they rot away for fear that they might be called to task for something that they believe is their sacred free will. Well, sacred free will comes along, beloved, when you have given obedience for a lifetime or lifetimes. The will of God is good. The will of God is the all power of Elohim. The will of God is the creation, the grund and the ungrund. Let the power of worlds, beginning and ending, be a part of your reality. I see the crystal cord. I see the causal body. Some whose causal body is high in the upper atmosphere tells me that you have not made resolution with your holy Christ self recently. This you must do ere the clock strikes December 31st. You must make your peace, beloved, else you will not be able to stand and still stand. It is a message that will be repeated during this conference, I am certain. Make all things right. Make all things right. When you do this and you are in that wondrous alignment of the love of God, the chastening love of God, when you are fearless before it and you enter that path and you love enough to love the ascended masters and to walk with us, there is nothing that we will not do for you as long as it is lawful. Chelas of the sacred fire know that the byword has been from the beginning of the Summit Lighthouse, constancy, constancy, and more constancy. That power, beloved, can bring a world to upper levels of being. Now I come, and I come and I touch those who are the sour notes. You sour notes have been around too long. You are the ones who have played off key. Now be gone, for my chelas are here on the mountain of God. And where are you, simply commiserating and condemning, whether the messenger or this one or that one? So, beloved, I have waited long enough for you to do this out of the office of ministry. Now I say, do it. Let this organization be purged, and let those who hang on and not resign, we will resign in their behalf for them. This is the message, beloved. There are so many moths around the flame that you can no longer find the flame. Well, I have found the flame. I have found the flame in every single chela of the will of God, and many whom you know not, such as those of the Far East. Yes, the Tibetans. Yes, those who have been ravaged again, once again by the Chinese. Yes, beloved, there is war in the earth, and I am a warrior of the spirit, and you have come with me. You have been with the god Mercury. You have been on that planet, and we are the quick ones. We are the ones who have the mind of God. We are the ones who act and act and act again, and we take our stand no matter what the cost, for we must defend life, innocent life, life that is weak, life that is ignorant, life that cannot put things together and be the magic of God. Yes, the magic of God. Are not all things created by God in that same magic of the alchemy of the violet flame, the alchemy of the seven mighty Elohim? Has this gift not been given to us, and have we not had this planet for tens of thousands of years and beyond, into infinity almost? Yes, it is the hour when we must say, we will save planet Earth in the name of Gautama Buddha, in the name of Sanat Kumara. We will save this planet, for God has shown us how to do it. Now we will do it. We will do it. We will do it, for not to do it, beloved, is to court death and ultimate death. There is only one course, and that course is victory. I speak of the representatives of the nations. I speak of those in this government and other governments. Beloved, there certainly is in many quarters representatives of this country and other countries who are a sham in themselves, who ought not to be representing the people. Therefore, I declare unto you that that seed of Lucifer has been planted in the proud who are already proud in the nations of the earth, and that pride aligns them with the fallen angels, and that is how they move, beloved. Go from nation to nation, and you will see this pride. Kill it in yourselves. Destroy it by sacred fire, by humility. Wear a hair shirt if you must, to remind yourself that there is a penance to be done if you are to be a part of those who are going to make this planet strong, make it hang together, and give hope to the people who have never heard of Saint Germain or the Violet Flame or the teachings of the Messenger. Now I have called her to go stumping. Now I call you to prepare to stump the nations, for I must keep this messenger in this country for the time being. And I ask you to consider what your training will be, where you will go in teams. You may not have another opportunity to do this, beloved. Therefore, consider well, what will you do with the coming year? What will you do with time and space? Kaldesh, what will you do with them? For these are the options in this physical universe. Each day you are spending time, spending space. Now economize, internalize, intensify within that fire of God, and go forth to conquer. I have seen worlds in much graver conditions, if you can believe that. I have seen those worlds. I have worked in those worlds. And we have brought them around. The ruler of the violet planet also knows this, for they did turn their planet around also with the intensity of violet flame. Yes, beloved, it is do or die. This is the moment of the telling. This is the moment of the victory. And this is the hour when there is no longer time to be on the fence. Are you with me, my beloved?
Yes!
Hear the determination, the very youngness of my being. Hear and see how I move across the quadrants of the earth. See how I am here and there and multiply myself many times over. This you will do once you have made your ascension. But in this octave, you must yet go forth. You must yet purge the earth. You must yet challenge the fallen ones. And beloved, the sweet, sweet taste of victory will be on your tongues for thousands of years to come, for the victory you shall win. Organize, determine what is the priority project. Where must you go? Where must the messenger go? I will be sending this messenger then to California to begin with, and I expect that she will go up and down the coast and bring the true message of Jesus Christ, bring the true understanding of what is the real path of Christianity, which has never actually been brought forth in all that it stands for, but been covered over by the false priests and the fallen angels. Is it not about time that we get up and we defend our Lord and Savior, and we show to the world, This is what these fallen angels have done. This is what these dark priests have said. This is their false doctrine. Now come out of the darkness and into the light and know and see that the twin pillars of karma and reincarnation are the very foundations of your victory. Think of this, beloved. Think how God has given you another lifetime and another lifetime, and how the Roman Church denies reincarnation and the Orthodox churches, and therefore one life, fail or succeed, and that is the end. It is the most nonsensical picture of life that could possibly be construed by the idiotic priests and councils that brought this definition of Jesus' message as the final ritual and doctrine of the Western Church. Blessed ones, I count on every one of you to read Jesus' book when it comes out, to know it backwards and forward, to underline it, to make cards, so that wherever you go and you find Christians arguing doctrine, you will say to them, I am not going to argue with you, for I know the truth, and I am going to give you that truth here and now. And if you will listen, I will tell you. And if you will not listen, then you will realize, nevertheless, when you pass on and must return, that you did reincarnate. And most people upon earth will have reincarnated by that time. Yes, beloved, it is an absolute travesty that the avatar of the Piscean Age, that theology has been so torn apart and twisted, that people cannot even understand what living and dying is all about, what sowing the good seed is all about, and whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. That doctrine of karma has been thrown away. That doctrine of reincarnation, the twin pillars of the West, and therefore, there is no stopping crime, there is no stopping abortion, because there is no understanding of the reality that he that killeth must be killed. And beloved, that is the word. Now you understand how concerned is the messenger and the Darjeeling Council that so many souls of light who should make their ascension have not been given the violet flame by their pastors, have not been given the true teachings of the Master Jesus Christ. Therefore, what will become of them? Most of them will have made enough karma to have to re-embody. And if they re-embody in the same old doctrine, they will believe again that they only have one life, for they will forget that they went to heaven and had to come back because they didn't have the violet flame or the teachings. As the life of Riley used to say, what a revolting development this is. So some of you may not remember that radio program, but I remember it. And this is the most revolting definition that I can come up with in all of history. So you see, beloved, how shall the root races come in? How shall the seventh root race appear? How shall these children have role models? Well, it is a wonder, beloved, but I tell you, so many are seeing through these councils and these fallen angels that they are leaving the churches en masse. And they are finding the inner truth of their own being. The year 1997, beloved, will not be an easy year. You can make your life far more difficult by lamenting this. I ask you to take the year. I ask you to take it. Intensify the white fire of being every day. Be absolutely positive. Do the things that you can do to stop major calamities, upheavals. Take care of elemental life. Their burden is heavy. Take care of the poor, the sick, the dying. Take care of yourself, beloved. And you will see transformation upon transformation. Transformation is based upon the alchemy of divine love. Transformation cannot exist without the alchemy of divine love. And divine love is a fountain ever flowing, overflowing. That fountain of love from your heart, beloved, can ultimately reach the whole world. This is possible, beloved. You may decide you want to be a bodhisattva, stay in embodiment with Earth's evolutions, or stay unascended with Kuan Yin, the goddess of mercy, the great bodhisattva of the East. Blessed ones, if you will take home the love fires of the lineage of Sanat Kumara Gautama Buddha, Lord Maitreya, Jesus, Padmasambhava, if you will remember that love and tend it daily and feel the heart fires intensifying, feel that burning within you, that burning within you. When the disciples walked with Jesus on the road to Emmaus, did our hearts not burn within us? For they had apparently not recognized their Lord until he revealed himself to them. Blessed ones, you can create fountains of love wherever you go. And the power of that love is the power that changes you first and then begins to change your aura, the expanding aura of being. And that love brings healing if you really trust that healing. That power of love can do stupendous things, but it must be predicated on absolute forgiveness, forgiveness, forgiveness. If you have not learned how to forgive, take a lesson from the messenger, for the messenger has explained that justice belongs to God, but forgiveness belongs to you. Therefore, there is justice for wrongdoing. That is God's province. Your province is to forgive and forgive again, and thereby to atone for past incarnations. I must report to you, beloved, that in this coming year, karma will descend at an accelerated rate. I am certain you have expected this. I speak then upon the point of acceleration. Acceleration of karma is a multiplication. It is a multiplication of that karma. So as long as you allow negative karma to be in the earth or in your four lower bodies, there is an acceleration of that karma. It's like paying a debt with interest. And so as you try to pay off that debt, the debt becomes heavier and heavier. And so you must discover how to increase the fire of the spoken word, the intensity of the fire of the spoken word. I do not want to find any one of you in this court who is not in his decree work giving all the fire of his chakras that he can muster to bring about change in himself and change in this world. When I see half-hearted decreers, when the messenger sees it, it is truly disheartening. For we know what a multiplication factor there can be when you take all the fire of your being and pour it in to the chalice of the word, the cups of the word. Beloved, do you think you lose something when you give all of your energy and your decrees? Do you really lose anything? Well, what do you lose? What do you lose, beloved? You spend. As the Apostle Paul said, spend and be spent. In a given day, you should have spent all of your energy, all of your white fire, all of your determination. And when you kneel and pray and you go to sleep at night, you can say to God, I have worked the works of God while it is day, while there is light. And what happens in the morning? You are fully recharged. You are fully infused. Diseases in your body have been consumed because of the power, the fiery power of the word you have given. Then you return to the altar and you give it again. And as you give it again and again and again, the aura multiplies, it increases. And some of your auras are becoming very large and very intense. So you see, beloved, it is a great loss if you do not pour whatever fire you have in your being into the chalices of your decree matrices. When you do not do this, you are losing the opportunity of that hour or that day to give your all to God. You must not fear to give your all to your mighty I Am Presence, for as I have just said, your mighty I Am Presence is going to give it back to you multiplied, and each and every day your spiral of victory increases. This is the pathway of the overcomers. This is the path of those who will make their ascension. What do you think it does, beloved, to your chakras to have such an intensity in that being? Because the power of the word flows through you, flows through you, flows through you. If we are to save a planet with a handful of people, then that handful must know their stuff, if you will. You must know how to get things done, how to multiply yourself, how to use technology to accelerate with the speed that is necessary to save the organization, save the planet, save the United States, yes, and above all, save the children who are on drugs, save the teens, and save even those who have gone through the entire period, the Timothy Leary, etc., and are still taking marijuana and marijuana brownies, etc. Blessed ones, this is a frightful planet. If we did not know that we have recourse to Elohim, to the Lord of the world, how do you think we of the Darjeeling Council would feel? Well, we do have that recourse. We do have you. We do have your hands and feet and your hearts. We do have all that you have given to us, and we are most grateful, and each and every one of the members of the Darjeeling Council who are meeting at this time are now standing in your honor in gratitude. Thank you, beloved, please be seated. Therefore, you count. You are not nobody, you are somebody. You are sealed in the heart of God. Go out and challenge your adversaries, as the messenger did do after she balanced 51% of her karma, to go out and challenge these fallen ones. No one ever said it was easy, beloved. It is the hardest thing in the world to deal with that 49% remaining of your karma. Go out and slay it. Purge it. Put the fire through it. Be stronger than anyone that moves against you. You have that strength. You have a mighty I Am Presence, and you know it. You have the power. You have the power to make your ascension. Yet some of you will not make your ascension because you do not use it. You do not use the fire. You do not use the power. What a tragedy to find this out when you are on the other side and without your three lower bodies. Well, I tell you, it is something to certainly mourn about. And I desire not to see any one of you lose the race of your own victory. The messenger has counseled you recently to take your attention off of yourself and put it on those who are far more needy. Forget yourself and your body will heal yourself. Focus on yourself, fail to forgive others, and you will constantly have problems in your body that will not go away. Look forward, and for goodness sake, beloved, for the sake of God, read the newspapers, look at what is going on and see how much worse off the millions of people on this planet are than you, because they do not have the violet flame. I ask those of you who represent the nations and the states who are on this patch, those who will hear this my dictation, I ask you to work right where you are, in your centers, in your groups, to consume, to vow, to stop all criticism, condemnation, and judgment and gossip. We would see that end, beloved, for we cannot send a messenger to a place where you are still carrying on this type of thing, this criticism, condemnation, judgment, and gossip. You can teach yourselves these things. I do not have to send a messenger to you to tell you how to do it. You simply must stop it, stop the old momentum, and bow to the Christ in everyone whom you meet. Blessed ones, there are things that you must do for yourselves, and when you do them, and you do them well, and then you call to me to send my messenger to you, well, then I will consider it indeed, but I will not consider it if you are not doing your part. It does not matter what country you hail from. People are different in every nation, but love is a universal unguent. It is a universal solvent. The power of divine love shall set you free from all that human consciousness. I ask you to be diligent about this. And when you catch yourself not being loving, write it down. Give yourself a penance and do it. Get out of that consciousness, beloved. It is a dastardly state of mind. And by the grace of Saint Germain and his sponsorship of the United States, beloved, that prevalence in this country is not as great as it is in other parts of the world. Well, beloved, make your part of the world a sunny place. Make it a place of joy and happiness. See the spiraling tower of Lord Himalaya's retreat. See the retreat of Devasvata Manu. See their retreats, beloved, and understand where they have come from, what they have given, and how they have descended to the levels of the human consciousness to the very help of humanity. Thus, in each of your nations, look at the most horrendous circumstances. Always consider that those circumstances are most horrendous upon the very little children and upon the babes. These little ones need the love and care, and they are often left to drift at a very early age and to go into the streets and so forth. Every nation should look at its military establishment, at its leadership, as what there is to be done in the face of the potential war, when there are nuclear equivalents, when there are warheads that are ready to be used, beloved. Many will be directed against this nation. They may be directed at other nations. But there are those in this world who would like to see the United States of America be no more. And therefore, they are amassing their weapons and they are amassing their technology. Make no bones about it, beloved. This is going on constantly all over the world. When and if there shall be a total Holocaust, I will not say. But I will say to you that every day that you have life and breath, you must work on the judgment of those who bring their engines of war. And they are always the godless, always the fallen angels, and most of them can be taken by the seven archangels with a simple call from you. Make that call, beloved, and rid this earth of those who are the spoilers. And they are the spoilers, and we have known them for eons. And we have come because we have seen that the children of the light on earth do not understand that equation of evil, and they do not want to believe that evil exists. Well, let them tell you that, beloved, but you know better. Look into, then, all aspects of your societies. What is detrimental? What is promoting the greatest good? And how you can insert into the various nations out of which you have come the teaching of the violet flame. The teaching of the violet flame. The teaching of the violet flame. I ask you to send that flame as you would hurl a comet if you were Hercules, and hurl it and let it travel round the earth and deposit that violet fire. Oh, so much good can happen if you are diligent with this daily. I speak then of the children, the very little ones. I speak of the teens. I speak of them at their most tender age and at that moment when they feel insecure and must move together because of that insecurity and do not necessarily have the wonderful teachers and guides that they might have. Here and there and about in this nation, there are adults who are definitely working with the young. There are schools where there are only children who are off drugs and off those kinds of activities that should not be. This is a wonderful thing, beloved. Would that it were a universal manifestation. Therefore, I ask you to pray for the youth of the world, to use that short prayer that I gave to you many years ago for the youth of the world. Take command of the youth today. This is a mandate. After all, beloved, if you all intend to make your ascension, you know very well who will inherit the earth. It will be those who are now in their teens and in their 20s. They shall inherit the land. They shall inherit this place also, for we are all moving on. Let us be up and doing then. Let us see that the levels of instruction in education in the United States especially goes back to phonics, goes back to children learning very early how to read and write. Then there is the problem of sugar, beloved, that causes them to be so yin that they can hardly think. Their brains have become so soft. Everywhere you look, there is an opportunity to serve. If you can't think of an opportunity, then just call upon me and I will direct you to one. Now, beloved, I think that you know to a great extent what is coming upon the earth if we do nothing, and what can happen in a glorious victory if we do everything. I am El Moria. I am one ascended master. I am the chief of the Darjeeling Council of the Great White Brotherhood. I bid you take this world in hand, remold it in the likeness of God, and see what you can do as the Elohim multiply your decrees. I am Moria. I move on to 1,000 points of light throughout the earth where many are in need of me in this very moment. I bow to you. Take hold of the new year, lest it take hold of you.